Hi everyone, this is Dr. Esther Mushemi speaking. Let me tell you something. The people I admire most are those people that are humble. And what is humility? For me, humility is a virtue that each and every person must either have or cultivate for, and especially when you want to be considered a successful entrepreneur, a successful teacher, a successful doctor, a successful engineer. Indeed, if you want to be successful and be recognized as a true successful person, you must cultivate and work towards being humble. And the humility that I'm talking about is not the humility where you necessarily walk like you don't have. You remember when we were growing up, the more you are poor, people used to think that you are humble. That is not the humility I'm talking about. I look at people like, for example, Manu Shadaria, a man who is so well established. And when he walks into a room, you can almost feel his humility. I look at Richard Branson, who is also my role model. And when you watch the way he does his thing, how he mingles with his staff, how he relates with the big and the mighty, you cannot but appreciate that he is a humble person. These two people I've talked about are people who, by any standards, are very wealthy. They are people who, by any standards, have excellent family relationships. These are people who have an excellent relationship with their God. Yet, in the midst of all that, they remain humble. So, what's the source of this humility? For me, the beginning of humility starts from the fear of God. Why do I say so? Because no matter how big you are, no matter how educated you are, no matter how rich you are, you must ever know and remember that there is always somebody better than you. And even if there isn't a physical person that is better than you, ever remember that God is above all. He is the creator of heaven and earth. He is the creator of that wealth that you so much treasure. He is the giver of that knowledge that you so much believe in. He is the giver of that fame that you are so boastful about. And the day he will feel that you are not using for his glory, he has the whole light to withdraw that light, to withdraw that knowledge, to withdraw that fame, and to withdraw everything that you may treasure from a human understanding. Therefore, for you to remain humble, for you to understand the importance of humility, first consider yourself as a person who can never ever even add a day, an hour, a minute to your life. Your life belongs to God and He has you in His heart. As a business person, because you all know my strength comes from the fact that I'm an entrepreneur, I have learned over time that humility allows you to achieve your vision in a much easier way than when you are operating from a place of pride. You are all aware of this saying that says, pride comes before a fall. And so, as you choose to become a successful business person, ever remember that when you choose a path of humility, it attracts people towards you. And when people are attracted to you, whether they are your workers, whether they are business partners, whether they are your creditors, whether they are your bank, the moment you attract people towards you, you automatically create an environment that will allow you to be more successful in a much easier way. You have all heard that never forget where you started from. Never forget your humble beginnings. Many people, as they climb the ladder, tend to forget that once upon a time, they were sleeping hungry. Once upon a time, they never had clothes. Indeed, some of us even forget that once upon a time, we lived in mud houses back in the village. And now that we are in town, now that we are living in beautiful mansions, now that we are driving the best cars, we tend to forget where we came from. My challenge to all of us, in whatever position you find yourself in now, whether you are a successful entrepreneur, whether you are a successful pastor, whether you are a successful teacher, whatever and however you define your success, I want to challenge you to truly believe in this virtue of remaining humble. It doesn't cost you anything to be humble, but it plays a big part in your ability not only to walk in the journey of success, but also in remaining up there. And also remember, in the unlikely event that you ever have to drop from that up position, people will always receive you better if you fall from a place of humility. But wait a minute. If you fall from a place of pride, honestly, the world will teach you a lesson. And I'm sure none of us want to be taught that lesson. Because my mother told me, asiyefundishwa na mamake, hufundishwa na dunia. Therefore, humble yourself before the world humbles you. This is Dr. Esther Muchemi speaking.